Hello students, welcome back to Evershine Coaching Center. Myself, Faisal sir. Okay, now dear students, today we are going to bring the topic theorems. Is this clear? Yeah. Now dear students, you can see the statement here, and this theorem is very important to not forget it. Done. Let me start solving the theorem. You can see the statement here, prove that the areas of similar triangles are proportional to the squares of the corresponding sides. In the previous class I said you that, so please try to ensure the terms areas of, can you see this, areas of similar triangle, this term, this terminology. You need to remember this keyword, areas of similar triangles, and next squares of the corresponding sides. Again here also, areas of similar triangles, can you see this, next square of the corresponding side. We can see this, both the sides. Is this clear? Now let me start solving the theorem. Now here we have to prove the areas of two similar triangles. Let me take two similar triangles, like I am going to take two similar triangles. This is one triangle and this is another triangle. Is this clear? And I am going to name this triangle as ABC and this triangle as DE and F. Okay, so first we should write the data. So you know what is the data? The areas of two similar triangles. So which are the two similar triangles? Triangle ABC and triangle DEF. So can we write like this? Let triangle ABC and triangle DEF be the similar triangles. Can we say? Can we say these both are similar triangles? Let triangle ABC and triangle DEF be the similar triangles. Done. Now, in this, if we take AB as the side, the corresponding side is BE. If we take AC, you should take DF. If we take BC, then you should take EF. Okay? Whichever the side you take, the corresponding side you have to take. Any one corresponding sides you have to take. Any one pair of corresponding sides. So let triangle ABC and triangle DF be the similar triangles, in which shall we take BC and EF? In which BC and EF are the corresponding sides. Okay, to solve this theorem, I am taking BC and EF are the corresponding sides. Done. Hope you are getting the steps, what I am saying. Okay. Now, just a minute. To prove that, now what we need to prove in this, what we have to prove, we need to prove here, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equals to, means areas, you can see the word here, ratio of what? Areas of two similar triangles, means ratio, means area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF, the ratio of these two triangles is equal to, the area of the ratio of these two triangles should be equal to squares of the corresponding sides. So which are the corresponding sides did we took here? BC and here EF, that is BC square by EF square. Is this clear? BC square by EF square. But please, you should not behead this theorem, just you have to see the figure and solve the answer, that's it. See, we have taken two triangles, one is triangle ABC and another is triangle DEF. These both are similar triangles, we have assumed, in which means already it is given in the statement, both are similar triangles, in which BC and EF are the corresponding sides. What we have to prove? Area of this first triangle by area of second triangle, the ratio ratio of these two triangles, the ratio of the areas of these two triangles should be equal to squares of the corresponding sides. That is what actually we have to prove. Done? Good. Next construction. Next part is what? Construction. Now, what we are going to do? We can see here. Draw AL perpendicular to BC and draw DM perpendicular to EF. Now what we are going to draw? We are going to draw AL perpendicular to BC and DM perpendicular to EF. Is this clear? So let me write the statement. So that is nothing but draw AL perpendicular to BC and DM perpendicular to EF. Done. Next we come back to proof. Now in proof, what we are supposed to do in the proof? Very simple. Okay, let's see. In proof, what we should do? See children, what is the LHS? What we have to prove? Area word. Just write area. That is area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF. Okay, is equals to, just draw one line. Just you write the reason here. What is the reason? We know that area of triangle is equals to half into base into height. Correct? Half into base into height. Now what we can do here? Now what can we do? See the figure. Look at to the figure. Okay, half into base into height. Just here you write half into. In this triangle ABC, what is base? BC. What is height? A. Simple. Done. Again DEF, half into base, EF, height, DM. Done. You can see the figure, triangle ABC. In this triangle ABC, BC is the base, AL is the height, altitude. Done. Again half into base is EF and height is DM. Okay. Now what we can do here? We can just cancel half and half. So what is left out here? We got here area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equals to BC by EF into AL by DM. Okay, let me call this as equation 1. Let me call this as equation 1. Now, can you see the figure again? Can you see the figure? Now, first what we had? ABC. We had ABC. Now, after drawing one perpendicular line, now this one triangle has divided into two sub-triangles. That is triangle ALB, triangle ALC. In first figure. Second figure, triangle DME and triangle DMF. So if you take this side triangle left side, here also you should take left. If you take right side, then here also you should take corresponding right side only. So now what I will do, I'll take left side part. What is the left side part? Triangle ALB. Here triangle DME. Correct? Shall we take two triangles? Triangle ALB. If you take left triangle, here also you should take left triangle. So in triangle, this is next part. In triangle ALB and triangle DME, if you want, you can just draw two triangles like this for your reference. This is A, this is L, and this is B. This is D, this is M, and this is E. Correct? In triangle ALB and triangle DME, I'll give one logic. Remember this logic. Which is the first word here? A. Which is the first word here? D. So start here from A, here you start from D. Okay. I'll use the logic here, that is left to left, right to right, top to top. What's the logic? Left to left, right to right, top to top. Left. means like this. Right means like this. Top means like this. I'll show you how. Left to left. Start from A. That is angle ALB. Left to left. Again here also you take left. DEM. So we know that angle A, sorry, left, right, sorry. ABL, correct, left, angle ABL, DEM, left to left, here ABL, here DEM, left to left, next right to right, ALB, here DME, right to right, then next top to top, what is top, angle BAL is equals to angle ADM, that means all the corresponding angles are equal. All the corresponding angles are equal, correct? Since all the corresponding angles are equal, we can say that therefore triangle ALB is similar to triangle DME. Triangle ALB is similar to triangle DME. Reason, how can you say these two triangles are similar? Because we know that triangles are equiangular. They have corresponding angles equal. Correct? Since triangles are equiangular, both the triangles are similar. If triangles are similar, then the corresponding sides are proportional. Right? If both the triangles are similar, the corresponding sides are proportional. Now, which are the corresponding sides we can take here? Simple. If we take AB, AB by DE. If you take left, here also you should take left. AB by D here. AL by DM is equals to BL. What is BL? Children's. This is very important step. We should not forget this. What is BL? It is a base. See our main diagram. What is BL? Base. What is BC? BC is also base. What is EM? Base. What is EF? It is also base. So here what I will be doing, instead of taking BL, I am giving this logic. Instead of taking BL, what we can do, we have to take BC. EL place, we have to take EF. We have three corresponding sides. Correct? Now out of these three, we have to choose any two. We have to choose any two. How to choose any two? See in the equation 1. In equation 1 part, can you see this? Can you see equation 1? What we want? We want BC by EF into EL by DM. Here also we choose this two itself. Done? Simple. So here also we can take, therefore, AL by DM, we have to choose any two. How to choose? Based on equation 1. AL by DM is equals to BC by EF. I'll call this as equation 2. Now, what we do here? Substitute equation 2 means AL by DM place. AL by DM value. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. What is equation 1? Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF is LHS. I'm going to write the same thing here. Area of triangle ABC divided by area of triangle DEF is equals to. See equation 1, what is there? In equation what we have, BC by EF into EL by DM. What is BC by EF? We'll write BC by EF as it is. We are going to write BC by EF as it is into EL by DM. In this case you can see. In this case. What is EL by DM? Sorry, in equation 2 you can see. In equation 2. Can you see here? In this step. Okay. In this step can you see? What is EL by DM? BC by EF. Now I will remove EL by DM. In that place I am going to substitute that as BC by EF. So therefore triangle ABC by area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equals to BC into BC, BC square, EF into EF, EF square. Hence proved. Hence proved. We have substituted equation 2 in equation 1. Now what was actually we need to prove? Can you see what we have to prove? Can you see here? In the to prove. This is TPT means to prove that. What we have to prove? Area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF equals BC square by EF square. Here also we have proved the same thing. Can you see here? area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equals to BC square by EF square. I hope you all have understood this theorem, right? So first what we took, let triangle ABC and triangle DEF be the similar triangles in which BC and EF are the corresponding sides. What we have to prove, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DEF is equals to BC square by EF square. Construction, draw AL perpendicular to BC, DM perpendicular to EF. That is construction. In proof, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF. Here area of triangle has come in LHS. So we know that area of triangle is half into base into height. I am applying this half into base into height formula for both the sides. That is area of triangle DEF. Area of triangle ABC is equals to half into base is BC. Height is AL. Correct? Again, similarly. By area of triangle DEF is equals to, apply the formula, area of triangle half into base EF height DM. Correct? Half of get cancelled. BC by EF into AL by DM. Done? Good. That is equation 1. Good? Now, let me take left side. If you want, you can take right side also. There is no issue in that. Okay, anyways. So, we can take area of triangle, in triangle ALB and triangle DME. Apply the logic left to left, right to right, top to top. So, that what happens? Triangle ALB is similar to triangle DME. Why? Because all the angles are equal. So, all the corresponding angles are equal. Done. That is the reason triangles are equiangular. Since triangles are equiangular, both the triangles are similar. Okay? Now, you can take left to left, right to right, top to top. Means, if the triangles are equiangular, then the corresponding sides are proportional. How two corresponding sides are proportional? AB by DE is equals to AL by DM is equals to BC by EF. Good? Now, out of these three, we have to choose any two. Which one we have to choose? AL by DM, BC by EF. Because in equation 1, we have same thing. What we have to prove? BC square. We want BC term. So, we keep BC as it is. AL by DM, we convert that as BC by EF. Good? Let me substitute that. So, area of triangle ABC by area of triangle DF is equals to BC by EF into AL by DM plus BC by EF. BC into BC, BC square. EF into EF, EF square. That's it. Simple. I hope you all have enjoyed while solving this theorem. So this theorem can be asked for 4 marks. You should not miss this theorem. Even in a textbook also they have shown what equation 2 I have written. They have done as equation 1 and 1 they have done as equation 2, but both are one and the same. You no need to get confused. Instead of BC square by EF square, even if you want, you can take AB square by DE square also. For any of the 3 sides, you can choose any one side. But one thing, BC by EF I have taken. Understood. If you take left side, then you should take left only. If you take right, you should take right only. If you take base, you should take base only. Okay? So, I hope you all have enjoyed the theorem and you have understood. So, please, again, you can practice this theorem by seeing this video. Okay? Is this clear? No doubts? Done. So, wish you all the best of luck. I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked, so please don't forget to like and share the video to your other friends. And even you can just ask your other friends to subscribe this channel of Evolution Coaching Groups, okay, in YouTube. So we'll be updating other theorems, other problems also, okay. Thank you. Wish you all the best of luck. And don't forget to comment. How did you like this theorem? Thank you.